let's say his hands up. Boom. That's why that one may not work.
So you turn back, boom.
See what happens.
Jab, cross.
Oh. The first one, most people are going to have their hands up for. Some people, you know, you'll turn back and it'll be such a surprise. But if he blocks it, this is not just an elbow, it's a... You see what I just did? Thank you for falling for it, Ken. Now, I don't want to finish here, right? Because I'm not in a good position, but if I did this... Now I'm going to try to finish, right? I wouldn't do this elbow straight across. I would do what we call like an overhand elbow. Right, like an umbrella coming up over my head.
Jab, cross, hook. Step, one elbow. Turn back, elbow. Square off, elbow. Tons of things. Now they go jab, cross, hook. Step, one. Step, two. Stand there for a second.
No, stay. I just said just stand there. No, I'm not going to do this one.
I thought you said stay there.
Stay. Roll over. Is the technique valid?
Yes.
Why? Because I went from here to here, and when I went back, I went from here to here. Yeah, loose. So would that not be? One more time. Maybe even just, if somebody just made one with my feet. Don't worry. Well, you know the hands already, right?
One, two, three. Step one, spin back two. Another one, I go one, two, three, step, boom.
I still come back here, and I still catch. I step here, right? So that, this doesn't have to be an elbow, right? Now, if I'm here also, there's also what we call implied footwork. It's not right in front of you. The best part about Chinese martial arts and the worst part about Chinese martial arts. It's best because if you know how to find it, it gives you great stuff, but most people don't know how to find it. So I go, jab, cross, hook, step one, step two, boom. That's the drill, right? Where is the implied? This is the form. This you have, right? So the implied part is here. And since I'm pulling him this way, this foot's going to go.